I hope this convinces you. Hi, my name is Brian. Welcome to another video on derivatives. In this video, we are going to show you the derivative of sine of x equals cosine of x, but we're going to prove it by looking at the graph of sine x I have here and show that the derivative of that graph is cosine x. Let's go ahead and get started. Let's sketch the graph of sine x. Okay, so 1, 2, 4. Okay. All right, so sine of 0 is 0. We'll make that sine of pi over 2, which is 1. Sine of pi, 0. 3 pi over 2, down here at negative 1. And then 2 pi back at 0. So it's going to look, at least the right-hand side is going to look like this. Okay. And then the right-hand side, since the period is 2 pi, we're going to have this is going to be identical on this side. So this is going to be negative pi over 2, which is negative 1. Then here's negative pi, and then negative 3 pi over 2, and 2 pi. The negative 2 pi might actually be off screen. Okay. This sine x. The way that we graph the derivative based on the graph of the original function is we take a look at the slopes at various points on sine of x. So I'm going to make a little table up here where I'm going to have the x and then the slope. So we'll start with let's actually start at 2 pi. Now, the slope would be the same as the slope of the tangent line at 2 pi. You may have to take my word for it that it is 1. You can confirm it by doing a table of values on all the secant lines. And then as those secant lines approach the tangent line, you'll see that the slope is 1. And then in 3 pi over 2, probably a little easier to see that the slope is 0. And then at pi, it actually mirrors at 2 pi, except now it's negative 1. At pi over 2, it is 0. And then back at 0, this actually matches right here, matches the slope here, which is going to be 1. Then at negative pi over 2, you will get negative 1, negative pi. Oops, sorry. Negative pi over 2 is 0. My mistake. Negative pi is negative 1. All right, so we'll do one more. Negative 3 pi over 2 right here. Slope is 0. All right, so then when we create the graph of the derivative, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, 2 pi. The y values on the derivative are going to be the same as the slopes on the original function. So actually, these points right here, like 2 pi, this is going to be the point on the derivative. So 2 pi comma 1. We're going to get 3 pi over 2 comma 0. Pi comma negative 1. Again, these are all the points on f prime. Okay, so let's just go through this. 2 pi comma 1 up here. 3 pi over 2 comma 0. Pi is negative 1. Then that will be 0. And at 0 we get 1. Okay, so if I connect the dots right now, it's going to look like this. Over on this side, at negative pi over 2, we're back at 0. negative pi is negative 1. Negative 3 pi over 2 is back at 0. Connect these. There you go. So hopefully you can see or guess that this is the graph of cosine. I hope this convinces you that the derivative of sine is in fact cosine. I hope this helps. Good luck.